Nice.
Hi everyone, today I want to talk about my favorite website for free fonts. I use it a lot for study and I thought I'd share it with you so you can check it out and also use it for study projects or other things. It is called Fontspace, and Fontspace is a website where you can find and download free fonts. It offers a wide collection of fonts ranging from simple and classic to more artistic and fancy styles. You can find different font styles under the style section. Yes, they got a lot of pages. And for example, if you're making a wedding invitation and need some IDs, you can click on the wedding category to see fonts related to wedding invitations. And you can also do this for study, Halloween, summer or Christmas. It is a sort of Pinterest, but then in fonts. In the collection section, you can see folders made by users with their favorite fonts. And you might find some fonts you like there too. If you want to make a collection yourself, it is possible, but you need to create an account for it and you need to be logged in. There is a feature called the font generator. I don't use it much myself, but you might have seen it on Instagram bios or other things. But some people use this feature to create cool effects in the Instagram bios or in WhatsApp. You can type something from yourself and easily copy and paste it. The same applies to the Lenny face generator. I didn't know it was called that. I remember it from MSN a long time ago. I now often encounter these faces in TikTok comments. And here you can create your own Lenny face expression, which can be quite amusing to try out. In the designer section, you will find fonts created by various designers. And you can also make and share your own fonts, but you need to sign up first. In the stuff section, you will find Fontspace sitemap. It is a handy tool if you need fonts for your website or fonts in another language. Yeah, they will explain to you what it does and how it works. And if you're looking for a specific font, you can use the search bar for it. Okay, back on the homepage, there are various buttons and I will explain what each of them does. In this box, you can type a word or sentence and see how it appears in different fonts, like what you can see now with easy to learn yourself. And when you adjust this knob, it makes the font bigger or smaller. It's depending on which way you slide it. You can also change the color, which is helpful if you're considering using a font for your website and want to see it in a different color before downloading it. And you can adjust both the font color and the background color. You can also add a font to your favorites by clicking the plus sign, but you need an account for that. And this button lets you download the font right away without needing an account. And there is also this button that lets you see how the font looks like on a dark website, and this is called night mode. And where does it lead you if you simply click on this font? Well, they will show you another tab with an image with the font, and you can see other information about the font, or if it's personal use or commercial use, and who the designer is. Just a quick summary of everything you need to know. And lastly, I'll explain what personal use and commercial use mean. But remember, this information might change over time, so it's always good to do your own research. Okay, personal use means that you can use the font for your own personal projects, like designing a birthday card or creating artwork for yourself, without needing to pay an additional fee. And I'm using the fonts mostly for my study in PowerPoint presentations. And commercial use, on the other hand, means that you can use the fonts for projects that generate revenue, so you earn money with it, or for business purposes, such as designing a logo, creating advertisements, or using the font on products you sell. For commercial use, you might have to buy a license for the font, or you must follow certain rules set by the Fontspace designers. The most important thing is to read Fontspace website carefully, especially the help section, and you can find it at the bottom of the page, and it explains things better. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below, and I do my best to assist you if you face any issues. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and don't forget to give it a like and consider subscribing.